I join you?
No, please do.
Will you excuse me for a minute?
Yes, of course.
Well, seeing you two together was worth losing the bet.
What?
I thought you'd be asleep by now.
Oh, she's a bit quiet, but she's a good listener. That's kind of nice. Especially as I'm the kind of guy who likes to hold the floor.
Good morning, Mr. Harrison.
Oh, morning, Miss Bennett.
I'll take over now if you'd like a cup of coffee.
Oh, thanks very much.
What's Smith doing out of solitary?
Well, Brooke spoke to Jim about it. Must be all right by him. Well, look, I'd like to thank you for having drinks with me last night.
There is a time and a place for socializing, Mr. Harrison, and this isn't one of them.
Well, when you choose the place, let me know and I'll see if I've got the time.
Can we sit by ourselves?
They're your friends, B. They care about you.
Well, I've ended up a bit. Well, your Margot's watching.
Oh, you're right.
Yeah. Well, I always say.
Stop. This is Judy. Doreen and Lizzie.
Hi, babe.
How are you feeling, love?
We've already met.
This lot should bring back a few memories, Smith. I take it you're still playing your stupid game.
I think she's taken about as much as she can from you, Miss Bennett.
You're very protective of someone who's responsible for you being back here.
I'm responsible for my own mistakes.
Oh, not even a touch of bitterness?
Bitterness is soul-destroying, as you well know.
Yeah!
We'll work back an hour for being insolent, all of you.
Hey, B, how about you trying to read my tea leaves and then you could sort of find out what we've been doing while you're away?
Yeah, like remembering how we all went on a hunger strike so you could come back from Barnhurst.
Will you lay off, Lizzie?
Come on, B, you can read tea leaves, can't you?
Yes, I can read them.
See, I gotcha. You do remember, don't you? You were having us on all the time.
No, no, I always read them at home for Debbie. It makes her laugh.
Shh.
One minute you're getting through to her, the next minute... I don't know, I just can't work her out.
Well, why bother?
Well, I've never had any trouble with women before.
Ah, ha, ha, the man's human after all. You've met your match at last.
Yeah, we'll see about that.
But look, mate, you've already had one lousy night. Why put yourself through another one?
I've had worse dates.
A word of advice. Steer clear.
Well, just forget I mentioned it, all right?
Look, I took her out once. I even made the mistake of a good night kiss. Next thing, you think I committed myself for life.
Jim, I don't want to know.
She's just a desperate old spinster, Terry.
Look, lay off it, will you, Jim? Just lay off.
I know you've had a little holiday, Smith, but you'll soon get back into the way of things. Now get moving.
Well, what do you want me to do?
I'm sure one of the others will help you.
You could help us fold sheets if you like.
I'm giving the orders around here.
What do you think about that?
I don't have to take orders from anyone.
You work the sewing machines or I'll smash your teeth in.
You come near me and I'll report you to the officers.
Busy, haven't you, Brooks? First talking Mr. Fletcher into getting Smith out of solitary and now bringing Mrs. Morris into it.
I'm sure it won't do any harm letting us see Smith for a minute, Miss Bennett.
I don't believe you can stand there and say that B's behaviour has been normal.
Oh, Mum.
I think you want to work in the laundry to make sure that Smith doesn't slip up.
Miss Bennett. I found Lizzie wandering down the corridor. She said she'd fallen over.
That's worse.
Must have hit me head, that's all.
Are you all right, Lizzie?
Who are you? Where am I? Oh, I must go. I'll be late getting the tea ready. I might miss me bus.
I think you can take her back to the laundry now, thank you, Mr. Harrison.
Well, shouldn't she at least see the sister?
Yeah, the sister.
Oh, I hope it's not permanent. Loss of memory at that age could mean a mental institution for life. A padded cell and that's all.
Miss Sam, they wouldn't do that to me, would they?
Miraculous recovery, don't you think?
I do indeed.
Nobody will give me a fair go.
Smith's amnesia seems to be catching.
Smith! Outside, Mrs. Morris wants to see you. Come on.
told you it wouldn't work.
Oh, Mrs. Morris tricked me.
That figures. You've been doing us a lot of favours since you've been working on the outside, haven't you, Mrs. Morris? Snitching on B, making sure Mum gets put back inside. I bet you feel real proud of yourself, eh?
Yeah, we never think.
All right, cut it out.
Once a screw, always a screw.
I said cut it out. All of you, get back to work. Come on.
That wasn't necessary, Doreen.
I say what's necessary or not, especially to someone who accuses me of stealing.
I did say I was sorry for my mistake.
Yeah. Well, I'm sensitive, see? It takes a lot more than that to make me feel better. But don't worry. I'll think of something.
First you ring the police and then you say you'll help me. Who the hell do you think you are?
What made you go to Mum's house? Or what did you remember about her?
Look, are you a psychiatrist or something?
No.
I'm not crazy. And they're not going to lock me away in one of their asylums, lady.
You know what you've done?
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah, they've all told me.
And you accept it?
Yesterday, I was a wife and mother. And today, I've got no daughter, no husband. And I'm told I'm dangerous and I've killed two people. And you ask me if I can accept it?
We'll get some help for you, Bea.
Just get me out of this madhouse. They've ruined my whole life. What more do they want?
I'll come back and see you later.
You think she's lying?
I doubt it.
Miss Bennet doesn't believe it.
Miss Bennet, she sometimes gets too close to her work.
You know her pretty well, don't you?
Vera?
Yeah.
Hmm.
Could you tell me something about her?
Why don't you ask her yourself?
Well, let's just say I like a few hints on how to get to know the lady first.
You must trust her, B. Mrs. Morris wants to help you.
No one else does.
I do.
You should hate me for what I've done to you. Seeing as how I was meant to have nicked it, I reckon you won't miss it now.
I need it and I'm keeping it.
Oh, don't hurt her! Get out of here!
You bitch!
I couldn't have done it. I'm not a killer. I didn't kill anyone.
What are you all doing to me?
No! He used to give I wish he could again, but that was on the outside, and things were different then.